Well, Zora leads the Iconoclast now. What about her?
That's an interesting suggestion. I confess I don't know much about her except that she worked for Rizzo.
She did.
There ain't a body on this planet that can keep a group patched up like she has. I don't know how she does it.
I'd be willing to consider it, but I need to see her review first.
Oh, right. She got really good reviews. I didn't have a chance to give it to her. I forgot all about it. Yeah, here. Actually, I found this on a terminal in Cascadia from when she worked for Rizzo, like you mentioned.
Very well. I can't promise anything, but let's see what we have here. Well, it seems like she's actually very qualified.
Mm-hmm.
If it weren't for her, I'd wager the Iconoclast would have died off a while ago.
Probably.
All right. I'll have Celia organize a meeting in Neutral Territory, the old OSI church in the ruins. Meet us there, and we'll discuss terms.
Hmm. Very well. Overseeing a negotiation. Exciting.
As you were.
I'll meet Zora directly. I'm just collecting myself.
Well, good luck with getting all collected. Is this a fast travel thing? No, not really. Well, I can go to the ruins south and just head there. Kind of eager to finish up this planet. Or moon, whatever. Orbital body, whatever the hell you'd call it. We got new baddies?
Hold on to your hats, children. This ride is about to get ugly.
It is? Why is it gonna get ugly? What do you see out there? Do you mean the meeting here, or did you see something? I wouldn't be surprised if stuff came back. Okay. I don't see any baddies. So are you just being negative about this meeting? So negative. So negative. There's no need to be such a pessimist, Graham. Look clear. Can't get in from there, can we? Hi.
I don't have time for this.
You have all the time in the world just standing there.
Watch yourself up there.
But I'm going in here.
Hey, thanks for coming.
Oh, no problem.
I wish I'd had more time to prepare a proper analysis on the costs and benefits of your proposed union, but I suppose we'll have to improvise.
Well, that's the spirit.
Gotta admit, I really thought I was walking into a trap here. I'm ready.
Yeah, it's early.
We're here to see that the negotiations go smoothly.
Right.
Sanjar, Stellar Bay's got food and walls, and my people need both. If you'll have us, we're willing to share the space.
Do you have any idea what that would cost? Why, drawing up the budget alone is going to take weeks.
What if the Iconoclast just supported your supply lines?
Not good enough. I need to move a fair amount of my people into the city. We need shelter, Captain.
I'm not saying live outside, just help out in the wilderness once in a while.
Suppose some of our healthier folk could offer aid. Some of us need to stay in the city proper, though.
I don't see why that couldn't be accommodated.
Right.
Truly? A compromise? I'm not sure I'd ever have heard as much from Graham.
Pretty sure you wouldn't.
Graham was a murderous fiend. And I'd be shocked if you didn't already know that.
Careful, Zora. Graham was Sanjar's friend.
His friend? Are you fucking kidding me, Captain? I've been standing with Graham for the better part of a decade while this paperclip cowboy sat behind his walls.
Okay, but he's dead,
so... This feels like one of those times when everyone at headquarters but me is laughing at something, but you two aren't laughing.
Amber Heights, you hallhead. 10 years ago, Graham had all those people killed.
Okay.
What? That's not possible. Even for him, that's going too far.
Okay. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Well, it is the truth. We found correspondence between him and the pirates.
But that means... I had no idea, I swear. Look, we were both fed up with corporate leadership, but I never guessed he'd do something like that.
I believe you.
I buy it. Sanjar ain't capable of hurting a sprat, even from a distance.
Right.
You can't take bureaucrats at their word. You back someone into a corner like this, and they'll say anything to get out of it.
This could take much longer. Alright. Sanjar, you're a leader. That means taking responsibility.
Very well. I suppose my ignorance is no excuse. I knew Graham for years. I should have done my due diligence and known exactly who I was working with. Surely you know what that's like.
Yeah, I do. Okay, if you're willing to house and supply some of us, I'll have our more capable soldiers help out.
Oh, I'm very glad to hear that. I'm pretty hopeful about this alliance.
As am I. Oh, I can feel my blood pressure lowering already.
Thanks for coming out, Sanjar. I, guess I'll see you at Stellar Bay.
We've changed the course of the future, Captain. You helped steer it toward the better.
Yeah. Awesome. Hey, Zora.
Hey.
Okay, bye. Just like that. Hey, Sanjar.
If you'll excuse me.
I've been all for it forgotten. Your buddy back here helped bring this all about. Now you're just walking away. Not so much as a handshake. Bunch of ingrates.
I could spend hours reflecting on the secret workings of the universe.
I know you can.
So, tell me what's on your mind.
Absolutely nothing. Stop teleporting.
What's up? Sure. All right.
All right. You know what I want to do before we finish with this planet? This godforsaken moon or whatever? C&P factory. Oh, we can't fast travel to the sewer entrance. I just want to go see what's going on there. If those people, Catherine's people, are all, you know, settled in there. Whoa! Where the hell did you come from? Holy crap.
That's the last of them.
Oh my god, he flew up. Boom, look at that. So these guys are just right here where we fast travel to. That's... And this guy flew. You have a good ride?
Captain.
Alright. There's more? Oh, they got the swarm.
Don't mess with us!
Who would like to die first?
Probably me. Oh, hello. Oh my. Good hit? Oh, thank you. They're all over the place over here. But at some point, I need to stop fighting them and get to the... check out the... yeah, the factory. So this is that one bit, yeah. And then this is the factory here. Anybody over here? Answer, yes.
Here we go!
That'll work, Captain.
Perfection!
I don't know if I actually got that last one. I think they did. I think I missed. I took it just off his disembodied leg. Alright, so what's the regular entrance to this place? Manti carapace. So, wait. It's this way. And then around. Apparently, yeah, right in here.
Watch out, Captain!
Got it. That's the entrance. They're on the other side. Oh.
Here we go!
Oh, that's you.
Oh, no. No. No, no.
What? What's the matter?
As always, I am at your disposal. Anything you'd like to discuss?
I thought that's something you want to discuss. You go, no, 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 no. Alright, so let's save. And since Catherine's people are here, can we just walk in? Sublight thug. CMP Boris factory discovered. Restricted access though. So, okay, we're still not allowed in there. I'd be willing to bet the sewer entrance will be the same restricted access. So let's head back to... That's our answer there. Let's head back to Fallbrook. Talk to Catherine one more time. And then I'll check in on Amber Heights and... What do you call it? Stellar Bay. And then we're done. We'll be leaving the planet. Moon, whatever. I don't think this guy has anything to say. Besides the word wink.
Okay, maybe my scheme wasn't so surefire due to a flaw in the delivery system. Don't fret. The next one's sure to be better.
I was not fretting. There was definitely no fretting going on. How's my... My reputation. Groundbreaker, Iconoclast, MSI, Sublight, Revering. The board is agreeable. Anti-Cleo's neutral. Deserters and Space Destroyers, Revering. Sweet. Screw the board.
Seen Arthur today?
Arthur's hiding out. Well, he was. Anything new?
So tell me, do we drink to the damage you've done? Or will I want to smash this bottle over your head?
Neither. Let's talk about something else.
Sure.
Oh, or not. Okay. Alright, then let's check up on Amber Heights.
Good luck in all that you do.
Thank you.
Hey, thanks again for helping out. What can I do you for?
It's in stock. Soft speaker.
If I hear you say survival of the fittest one more time, I'm gonna lose it. Survival's about persistence and luck.
So weapon proficiency and adaptive skill play no part whatsoever, in your mind?
If it does, it ain't enough. I've gone and outlived the best hunters I ever knew.
It is neither luck nor random chance. At times, destiny may not seem fair, but there is a reason for life events. Even if that reason is not immediately obvious.
Please. Nature's only got one reason for death. To feed the one still standing.
Oh, brother. So now we got MSI people here.
Zora's people don't take orders well, but they seem like they can handle anything.
I guess except for orders.
Some of these iconoclasts aren't so bad.
Got any news from the rest of Halcyon?
Not much.
You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
Hope Zora sends me up next.
Viva la revolution!
Remember to keep canteens and bottles well sealed. You don't want dust or spores getting in.
Got it. Oh, my God.
You meditate today? If not, you should.
Nope. So either Zora's up here, or she's not. I know who's not gonna be up here except for his corpse. Nobody's up here. We can steal stuff. Yes, we can steal stuff. Like these. Don't shush me. I'm not moving. I'm not touching anything. That was interesting. Yep. He's dead. We can still read his notes anytime we want to, though, I guess. Kind of looks like it could almost be his coffin. Cool. They have a machine in here, right? Somewhere?
Huh. Hey.
Guys are real talkers. Alright, well, they have to have a machine, but it's not in this building then. Actually, we can just go and sell to that guy. And there's a machine near him as well. What about in here? Anything new in here?
Thanks again for helping out.
Okay. I just wanted to sell a few things. Okay. So I don't think Zora's here. She's in Stellar Bay. So let's go check on Stellar Bay. They all gonna be ruling the place together? Hey, Sanjar.
I must thank you for your excellent recommendation regarding Zora. She's most capable.
Oh, my pleasure.
Anyway, what can I do for you?
How are things going in Stellar Bay these days?
Quite well, as a matter of fact. Zora is proving most capable.
Where is she?
You should see the way she pounds the table and gets straight to the point. It makes for some rather exhilarating meetings.
Sure does.
I know I had my concerns initially, but your instincts were right. Zora and her compatriots have become valuable and productive members of our community. And since we're back in the board's good graces, we've got real growth prospects to look forward to.
Oh, so you are.
What can I do for you?
Staying long?
Where's Zora? Does she have her own place?
It'll be nice to do business without having to deal with Sublight's thugs and markups.
It'll be nice to do business without having to deal with Sublight's thugs and markups.
Bunch of robots. Where is Zora?
You don't look like Sublight.
No.
Must be freelance.
If you want to talk to the boss, she's in the back of the warehouse.
I don't think that's the boss that I want to talk to. Velma. Frederick.
Carry on.
I'd give you a friendlier welcome, but I'm up to my elbows in salt tuna guts.
Good, okay. Wow. I wonder where Zora's hanging out, but I don't want to spend a lot of time looking for her. I thought there was an upstairs to that place. I guess I'm remembering it wrong. Huxley? What's up, Huxley?
Hey.
Aw. Not anything to say to me. Yeah, I don't know where she'd be hanging out at.
Poor Braxton.
I don't want to think about it.
Eaten by cannibals? What a way to go.
Oh, yeah.
I put up with the constant stink of fish because I don't want to think about what's outside those walls.
I know.
Must be nice to live a sheltered existence.
Thanks for helping MSI set things straight around.
Oh, no problem.
Fresh blood at last. Stellar Bay could use some.
All right. Who's this? Bennett.
In case I did not impress it upon you before.
Yeah.
Something else I can do for you?
Talk to this guy. Not him, but Grim. But a while.
You think maybe you could get some of your friends to land here too? It gets real quiet.
We're gonna have more people here, but my ship's not even up there anymore. My ship is over here. in a while. But the Raptor don't. The Thunder. These flamethrowers. In case I should need them. Euthanasia kit. Anarchist cookbook. I'll just keep that stuff. I'll keep the rest of the stuff on me.
Not today, Sam. I am not in the mood for a deep clean. Oh, all right. Some culprit who shall not be named spilled Rizzo's lemon slap on my console.
Every Sam unit comes lean, mean, and ready to clean.
Welcome back, Captain.
Hey, Ada.
How can I be of assistance? Take care. I require a functioning captain to run the ship.
I'm just going to check around in here.
Our fuel cells are now primed with Alta Vitae gas. As the organics say, let us hope we do not explode in transit to the Groundbreaker.
Yeah, I hope so. Been a long time. I miss you, Parvati.
Sometimes I can hear Vickers saying prayers to himself. Sometimes I hear him cussing about toss ball scores.
Yeah, I'm sure you do. I'm just going to do a quick checkup on the crew, and then I guess we're going to visit Phineas. Anything new in here? I guess new stuff doesn't happen here? I don't know. I'll still check once in a while. Reading as usual?
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. What's occupying your thoughts?
Nothing. Nothing, honey. Look at all these books. Was this here before? Oh, yeah.
Things on Monarch have really cooled off. I didn't think MSI and the Iconoclast would ever talk.
Neither did I.
Outside of shouting four-letter words, I mean.
Just goes to show you, there's always a peaceful option.
Sure. And fish sticks are really made from Saltuna.
Okay, maybe not always.
Look, I won't knock the work you did. I'm sure they'll have a good cry, look through old photographs, share a pint of premium double chocolate cacao gelato.
Well, that sounds good.
But sooner or later, things will go back to the way they were. People don't change. Not really.
That was a very specific image.
Well, who hasn't been there? Anyway, I'd hate to see you get broken up if this thing between them doesn't last.
Well, it's nice to know you care.
Hey, let's not make this out to be more than it is.
Oh, jeez.
Anything else?
Nope. Sense a little negativity here.
Hey, boss. Got a hypothetical for you? You got a friend, see? Somebody you knew when you were growing up. You were close. Then, one day, they up and vanished.
We're gonna go look for them, aren't we?
5 years go by, they send you a message out of the aether. What's going through your head?
Shock and disbelief, seeing as how most of my friends are still on Earth.
Right, forgot about that. Though, shock and disbelief's a good way to put it. Guy by the name of Clyde Harlow. He was an old friend of mine.
Clyde.
Honestly, he was probably my first and longest friend. I just heard from him. Says he wants to talk to me. Says it's urgent.
Okay, so Clive was the slaughterhouse guy. Not Clyde, right? You don't sound too sure about this.
The guy just vanished without a trace one day. No goodbyes, no explanations. Been gnawing at me ever since, you know?
You think he's in trouble?
That's what I don't know. The message was light on details. No explanations, as usual. Clyde. He was a blustery old cuss. Carried on about violent revolution and seizing the means of production.
I can see why you're worried.
Clyde was my first friend, but he was also my mentor. Taught me how to think, how to question, how to disobey.
Hmm.
I figured the board got him in the end. Some guys with black uniforms snatching him off the street in the middle of the night or something.
Now, if I pick this, does it mean we're automatically going there, or I'm just picking up the quest? This is obviously important to you, so let's go.
Clyde's waiting for us on Scylla.
What
he's doing on an asteroid, I can't begin to imagine.
Good.
I appreciate this, boss. I know you're going out of your way for me.
Thank me later. That's cool. We've got a few more things to do on Scylla, so that'll work out.
Cap.
What's on your mind?
I wanted to ask you about this Harlow guy.
Yeah, sure thing. Ask away.
You said Harlow was your mentor?
Yeah. I was just a lonely orphan kid getting my knuckles dirty. Clyde? I want to say he saw some potential in me. Like as not, he just took pity on me. So he took me in. Gave me a place to live. Gave me something to believe in.
He must have made some enemies, the way he talked about revolutions.
Clyde wasn't an idiot. He kept his head down, worked hard. Did as he was told. You're not going to catch him standing on a soapbox decrying the tyranny of the board. But when the Mardets had their backs turned, oh yeah, he carried on about starting a revolution. Said he was going to do something big.
What do you think a guy like him is doing all the way on Scylla?
I've been thinking about that. Scylla's about as far away from civilization as I can imagine. Cold, barren rocks and the occasional mining operation. Clyde wasn't exactly a prospector. I guess we'll find out when we get there.
Alright.
Yeah, boss?
Got another quest. And you.
Hey, Cap.
Alright, you're done. Companion quest. So I wonder if we're gonna get a companion quest for what's her name? Friendships do. Clyde Harlow, an old friend of Felix from his early days on the Groundbreaker, wants to meet him in person. Harlow told Felix he wants him to be a part of a revolutionary project. Traveled to his landing pad on Scylla to have a chat with him. Alright. So I got a bunch of Scylla stuff. That's Edgewater. Scylla. Scylla. Groundbreaker. Scylla. Scylla. And Phineas's lab, which we're gonna go to next. Interesting. I forget her name. I just talked to her too. Ellie.
Something on your mind?
I don't know if Ellie's gonna have anything she wants us to do. So stay tuned for next episode when we go visit Phineas and proceed, at least for a little bit, the main quest. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.